Hello, so today we're going to be doing something slightly different to our usual full out workouts. We're going to be having a stretch day today. We often neglect stretching and I think we forget the importance of stretching. So I wanted to really exaggerate it for this section of GNX Fitness. We're going to be doing a lower back pain and hip pain stretch, or as well, not just pain, but for tension also, because it's quite a confusing time at the moment. So we could be holding a lot of tension in these areas, especially if we're doing things we don't usually do, such as sitting at the desk a lot, or even just sitting and watching a lot of TV. So we're going to work on these and hopefully you're going to feel much more relaxed and much more relieved after we're done. Enjoy.
Start standing hip width apart at the end of our mat. We're going to take our hands up above our head, reaching up for the sky as high as you can. Take a large breath in, and as we exhale, we're going to bring it all the way down to the floor, just as far as you can. I don't want you to put your hands on anywhere. I want you to lift them, keep them up off the floor, relax your head, let your head and your body weight hang. So this is going to really exaggerate the stretch of the back of your hamstrings. If you feel the need to, you can bend your legs a little bit if it's too painful or you can't get far enough down, that's fine. And we're just going to take a little swing here, just small, nothing big. You should feel this right up the backs of your hamstrings. Nice small swings. Good. Let everything. Further to put your hands down, that's absolutely fine. And we're going to take our feet out slightly wider. Again, if you need a bend in the knee, no problem at all, because we are just going to lower our head a little bit further down towards the floor, keeping your heels firmly on the floor, taking as wide a stance as you need, and a small bend in the knees if you need to as well. I'm just going to take a few seconds to breathe here. Supporting your head with your hands, do not let it hit the floor. Nice deep breaths. Staying here for just a few more seconds. And then walking your hands slowly back up, bending your knees and curling up so your head is the last thing up. You're now going to take a nice wide stance. Get as low as you can. Take your feet out as far as you need to. And you're going to take your hands just above your knees. And then you're going to twist in and apply a small amount of pressure to the inside of your knees, stretching out that inner thigh and those hips. And breathing in to the center, breathing out, pushing over to the other side. Trying to stay nice and straight, do not scrunch up too much. Keep a nice gap between your shoulders and your ears. Swaying it a little bit if it feels right. Good. From this position, we're going to relax all the way down, bring our feet in a tiny bit further, and then use our elbows to apply some pressure into the crease of our knees. And this is a nice hip stretch, just taking it as low as you can. If you need your feet out a bit further, that's fine too. As long as you can feel it stretch through your hips, that is the main aim. Applying a little bit of pressure, very nice. Bring here, test how far we can, push how much pressure we can apply, so the stretch is bearable and effective. Good, so from here, you're just going to take it down onto our knees. I'm going to nice and taller. You're trying to get your head right up to the ceiling, all the way up. And just sitting here, relaxed, taking a moment to be in the moment before we tuck our knees up towards our chest. We're going to split them slightly. We're going to take our arms underneath and bring our head in between our knees and just relax here. Hug your knees right into your chest, head between your knees, hugging them nice and tight. And we're just going to take a few breaths right here. Relaxing more as you go. Nothing should feel like it's holding any tension. No muscle should be contracted. Even think about relaxing your fingers and your toes. Nice. Okay, we're going to come up nice and slowly from our tuck position. And we're going to straighten one leg out in front of us and hug the bent leg as tightly as we can into our chest. Bringing our head down, releasing our head, holding no tension in our neck. Wherever feels most comfortable, we just want you to relax, hug in.
Under the knee of the straight leg. And again, we're going to reach up with the opposite.
We're going to slowly roll through each vertebrae, starting with our lower back, until we are flat onto the floor. Just laying back here, letting your legs hang. That's going to add some resistance to that stretch. You're going to feel it right in your inner thigh, right in your hips.
Reaching
for the side of the opposite foot, curling back up again, reaching back. This is a nice low back movement, reaching out and really keeping it in one flowy movement. We want a nice flow in this to reach back and over. All designed for the back. Last time here and over, coming up. Perfect. We're going to lie back down, bending our legs as if we're going to do a glute bridge, except this time we're only doing half of a glute bridge. So your upper back and your shoulders are staying glued down onto the floor, and you're literally just contracting that pelvis upwards, tipping the pelvis up towards the ceiling, and then coming back down again. And this time we're going to bring it further off, a bit of our lower back's coming off, and then we're curling back down again. And again, just a small one, just your pelvis curling up, contracting in, your abs are going to contract in and down, and then a bigger contraction and curling all the way back down again. Okay, we're going to finish here now. You can finish lying just like this, or we're going to finish with our legs propped up against the wall, bum in as close as we can. This is going to be our last batch. So for our final lower back stretch, you're going to bring your feet up towards the wall, and I want you to scooch in as close as you can, nice and gently. Get that bum in as close as you can to the wall. Doesn't matter how close you get, just so long as you can start to feel a little bit of a stretch in your lower back. Take one hand on your heart and the other hand is going to sit on your stomach. I want you to close your eyes just for a second. Relax everything in your body. You should not have a muscle contracting, not even your toes, not your fingers. Just relaxing here, taking a moment to bring yourself back into the real world. Focusing on your heartbeat. Stomach moves up and down with every breath. Nice and deep. We just want to make sure that we're relieving all that final tension in the body. It's quite confusing and a stressful time right now. We've had a lot of changes, so we can hold a lot of tension in our back and our hips. In fact, I had a tip from a yoga person telling me that you hold all of your emotional tension within your hips, so hopefully after this you feel cleansed of any emotional tension. As when you stretch the hips and release it all, you cleanse yourself, so you might find yourself feeling a little tiny bit emotional after this, but apparently that's completely normal. But if not, you should just feel stretched and relaxed, hopefully ready for the rest of the week, ready for the rest of our life. I want you to open your eyes, bring your feet down the wall, and come up however's comfortable for you, nice and slowly. I hope you enjoyed that. I know it's slightly different, it's not as hardcore as our usual workouts, but it's just as vital and just as important. I'll see you soon.